Two other Isurim on Tisha B'Av. First is called Sicha, and the second is called Nilat HaSandal. Sicha means that you're not allowed to put oil or any other kind of substance on your body. Of course, those days they did it, and today also, if you go for a massage, you may do it for pleasure, do it to enjoy yourself. But it's important to know that if the sicha is for medical reasons, if you're putting a salve on part of your body, etc., or if a person has serious burns or sores on some part of his body, then it is mutar to put a salve on those sores. For tzorech refu'i, for the purpose of a medical purpose, it is mutar. For enjoyment, it is prohibited. It is unacceptable. That's what the halacha is of sicha. It's true that today we don't do this often. We don't anoint ourselves with oil on a regular basis. Although, as I said at the beginning, sometimes you go to get a massage and they just anoint with oil like crazy. But we're talking about regular life, a regular existence. Not so the isser of wearing leather shoes. You're not allowed to wear leather shoes on Tisha B'Av, and some poskim say that if they are not made of leather, then you can wear them. But there's a chumrah involved in wearing these shoes, and that is that the shoes should not give you too much comfort. Like, you know, there are shoes that are built specially to be comforting. In the time you wear them, they have inner soles and special kinds of, especially because they're built up in a special kind of way. Maybe those shoes should also be avoided on Tisha B'Av. This fact, it's easy enough to keep this halakha today. There are plenty of shoes in the market. That fulfill this requirement. It's important to know that sometimes the material that shoes are made of doesn't always look as it might look. So you have to make sure that the shoes that you have are not made out of leather. Even though they look like they're not made out of leather, that doesn't necessarily mean that they are not. So there's sicha, anointing. Not wearing shoes that are made out of leather, that's an easy enough thing to do. Some people are machmeh to try to get shoes that don't have inner soles or are not especially comfortable for the day of Tisha B'Av. And the last prohibition, of course, on Tisha B'Av is the prohibition against intercourse. The married couple is not to have intercourse on that night. So all of these things are perceived as achila and shtiya, as well as the others, are perceived as moments of pleasure and joy in the world in which we live. And since Tisha B'Av is as it is, such a tremendous national tragedy, we try to think about the tragedy in the context of lessening our dependence on these moments of joy, which might change our attitude. So remember, Tisha B'Av, of course, is a pattern to a certain extent after the laws of Avelut, of mourning, to a certain extent on the laws of Yom HaKippurim, from which we learn about fasting, and the other inuyim, right, the other ways we oppress ourselves on Yom HaKippurim. And Chachamim obviously thought that since Tisha B'Av is a day that begins at sundown and goes on for 25 hours, as opposed to the other tzomot, with the other fast days, where the halachot of fasting only apply during the day, Chazal obviously thought that we should take a special care in considering the importance of Tisha B'Av, and the halachot are supportive of this general interest.